it looked as though soul was now the imprint, was now the rubric forever. But I had a hunch, and I even told my partner, I think it was maybe 68 or 69, I said, I have a feeling this is going to grind to a shuddering halt. I felt new things happening. One thing is what you call the rising aspirations of the inner city, that they were looking toward other things than this kind of so-called religious church-based music. There was a new spirit. It was more secular. But of course, the thing that really seemed to cap it was the assassination of Dr. King.
When we got the news, we were in the recording studio here recording. I don't recall what song we were doing, but the whole mood and the whole atmosphere in the studio suddenly changed, and the session went downhill, and we called off the session, in fact, out of respect to him and everything. But and I'm not sure that the mood of black music didn't change along with that night.
From that point on, the rhythm and blues acts stopped coming to work with us after that night. I do remember that, and it was a sad occasion in a lot of respects for us.
There was a different attitude. The dreamer had died, and many of us who had lived that, we really wondered if the dream had died with the dreamer. So some of that was reflected, or a good deal of that was reflected in our attitudes, and of course that was reflected in how the songs were written, and how we sang the songs, and how we related to each other.
Going to Stax was like going to church for me every day. Absolutely. I couldn't wait to get up in the morning and get back there. I used to work 15, 16 hours a day at Stax. But somehow after that happened, it all kind of changed. Everybody was a little more serious about life and things, and particular about stuff.
Because when the way and the wind is dry right now. But all we need is you, Jesus, to linger right here.
The death of Martin Luther King was the most dramatic in a series of turning points for black music in America. Otis Redding had died in a plane crash at the end of 1967. Race riots tore apart Detroit. And Berry Gordy gradually moved his operation to Hollywood. In the fall of 1968, James Brown's Say It Loud, I'm Black and I'm Proud seemed to signal the decline of gospel-based melodic music and the rise in popularity of more aggressively rhythmic black music known as funk. For many black artists, crossing over had become less important than making a statement of identity and independence.
Rock and roll, England gets the blues.
The only music that appealed to me at all was black rhythm and blues.
While musicians everywhere start to turn on.
Psychedelic music is music that expands your awareness, your consciousness.
The Yardbirds, Cream, Hendrix and the Dead, tomorrow on Rock and Roll.
Say it loud. I'm black and proud. Say it loud. I'm black and proud. Lord, Lord, Lord.
production of WGBH, Boston. Funding for Rock and Roll is provided by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. The annual financial support of viewers like you. The Experience Music Project, a celebration of creativity and innovation through American popular music and culture, opening in Seattle in 1998. The National Endowment for the Arts.
Radio Shack, official sponsor of the house that Rock built, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and Museum in Cleveland, Ohio.
And by the Boston Beer Company, brewers of Samuel Adams. Do you love beer?
Educators and educational institutions can purchase the Rock and Roll series on video cassette. To order, call 1-800-255-9424.
This is PBS.